This video is going to be about converting numbers that are in non-base 10 systems into our own base 10 system. And I'm going to do another video which shows how to go from base 10 to other bases. So let's take a look at base 10 before we get going with actually converting things. Let's say I've got a number like 5,378. As you probably know, we say that the 5 is in the thousands column, and the 3 is in the hundreds column, the 7 is in the tens column, and the 8 is in the ones column. Now we can write these numbers, the column names, as powers of 10, powers of our base. So 1,000 is 10 to the third, and 100 is 10 squared, 10 is just 10 to the first, and 1 is 10 to the zero. And then we can think of that first number, that 5,000, as being 5 times 10 to the third, or 5 times 1,000. And the 3 is 3 times 10 squared. And so on with the 7 and the 8. Okay? So let's take that information and convert from some other base into base 10. So here I've got the number 2132 base 4. I'm not saying 2,132, because numbers like 2,000 and 100 are base 10 numbers, 1,000 and 100. So we'll just call this 2,132 base 4. I'm going to write those numbers again with a little more room between them, 2,132. And they're all going to be in a column that is some power of 4. Well, going from the right, it's going to be 4 to the 0 power. And then after that is 4 to the first power, 4 to the second power, and 4 to the third power, just like we did with our base 10. And now I'm going to write these powers of 4 as just normal numbers that you're used to. So 4 to the third is 64, and 4 squared is 16. 4 to the first is 4, and 4 to the 0 is 1. So I've got a 2 in this first left-hand 4 to the third column. So that means I've got 2 times 4 to the third, or 2 times 64. And I've got a 1 in the next column, in the 4 squared column. So that's going to be 1 times 4 squared, or 1 times 16. In the next column, I've got a 3 in the 4 to the first column. So that's going to be 3 times 4. And in the last column, I've got a 2, and that'll be 2 times 1, because that's the 4 to the 0 column. So let's multiply these out. 2 times 64 is 128, plus 1 times 16 is 16, plus 3 times 4 is 12, plus 2 times 1 is 2. And now if we add those up, 128 plus 16 is 144. 144 plus 12 is 156. And 156 plus 2 is 158. So that means that 2132 base 4 is equal to 158 base 10. Okay? Let's try a different number and a different power. Here's the number 110101, and that's base 2. Base 2 system is sometimes called the binary system. And this is the language, the number language, that's used in computers. Okay, so let's write this 110101. Let's write that out with a little more space like we did with the other number. And I'll put a little 2 over each one, and we'll figure out what power each one is. So going from the right, we know we're starting with 2 to the 0. Then we have 2 to the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and 5th. And again, going from the right, 2 to the 0 is just a 1. 2 to the 1st is a 2. Then 2 squared is a 4. 2 to the 3rd is 8. 2 to the 4th is 16. And 2 to the 5th is 32. So we've got a 1 in the very first left-hand column. So that means I've got 1 times 2 to the 5th, or 1 times 32, which is just 32. And I've got 1 in the next column, in the 2 to the 4th column, that's 16. So I'll add a 16 to this. I've got a 0 in the 2 to the 3rd column, so I won't have anything here. I've got a 1 in the 2 squared column, so that's going to mean I add a 4. I've got a 0 in the 2 to the 1st column, so there's nothing there. And I've got a 1 in the 2 to the 0 column, so I'll have a 1. Now I just have to add these numbers up. 32 plus 16 is 48, plus 4 is 52, plus 1 more is 53. So this number, 110101, base 2, is equal to 53 in our base 10 system. Now, you could have systems that have more digits than ours, than 10. In other words, as I'm going to show you here, you can have a base 16 system. Well, when you have a base 16 system, we start using letters because we run out of the digits we're used to in our own system. So the digits 0 through 9 are going to equal 0 through 9. So 0 equals 0, 1 equals 1, and then we'll go down 9 equals 9. But we're not going to write a 10. Then we're going to go to letters, A, B, C, D, E, and F. That'll get us 16 digits. The A is going to equal our 10. The B will be 11, and then C is 12, D is 13, E is 14, and F is 15. Okay, so let's see what we can do with this number 2AE, base 16. So 2AE, each of those is a power of 16. I'll write a 16 above each one. And the E is in the 16 to the 0 power column. The A is in the 16 to the 1st power column. And the 2 is in the 16 to the 2nd power column. Writing in what those things equal, 16 squared is 256. 16 to the 1st power is just 16. And 16 to the 0 power is 1. So that 2 in the first column in the 16 squared column means I have 2 times 256. And the A in the 16 to the first column, let's see, A equals 10. So that means I have 10 times 16. And the E, which is 14 in the 16 to the 0 column, means I have 14 times 1. Now I can multiply these three numbers out and find out what I want to add together. So 2 times 256 is 512. And 10 times 16 is 160. And 14 times 1 is 14. Okay, so I have 512 plus 160, so that'll be 172. And then I'm adding 14 more, so it's 686. So 2AE base 16 equals 686 base 10. Okay? And that's basically the way this works when we're going from some non-base 10 system to a base 10 system. I'm going to come back with another video showing you how to go from base 10 to other systems. So stick around and I'll be right back with that one.